Today we're going to talk about conformal hypergraphs. For simplicity, we'll consider only hypergraphs that do not have repeated edges, allowing us to define the collection of edges of a hypergraph as a set of sets. A hypergraph is conformal when the set of maximal clicks of its two section is the same as the set of its maximal by inclusion edges. For hypergraphs without included edges, this can be simplified to: a hypergraph is conformal when the set of maximal clicks of its two section is the same as its set of edges. Recall that a two section is the ordinary graph built from a hypergraph using the same vertices as the hypergraph, and where two vertices are adjacent if they share an incident edge in the hypergraph. In the example shown here, if we list out the maximal clicks of the two section, and then list out the maximal by inclusion edges of our hypergraph, you'll see that the two lists are the same, meaning the hypergraph shown here is a conformal hypergraph. Notice that if a hypergraph has an isolated vertex, that vertex is a maximal one click in the two section that is not a maximal by inclusion edge in the hypergraph. This demonstrates that hypergraphs with isolated vertices can't be conformal. Also, under our current definition, a hypergraph with at least one vertex and only one edge that happens to also be an empty edge would not be considered conformal. Here's a less trivial example of a non-conformal hypergraph. Moving on, let's look at two theorems that can help us determine whether a hypergraph is conformal. Our first theorem is: a hypergraph is conformal if and only if every set of vertices inducing a click in the two section is contained by some edge in the hypergraph. What this theorem is really saying is that conformality is equivalent to always being able to find an edge containing any click in the two section. Let's prove one direction at a time. Suppose a hypergraph H is conformal, and let Y be a set of vertices that induce a click in the two section of H. We know that in a graph, such as our two section, a click is a subset of at least one maximal click. So let Z be a maximal click that contains Y. By our assumption that H was a conformal hypergraph, Z must be an edge in H, specifically a maximal by inclusion edge. So we can now say that if H is conformal, then every set of vertices inducing a click in the two section is contained by some edge in the hypergraph. Now, why is the other direction of our theorem true? The fundamental idea to keep in mind is that edges in the hypergraph are always clicks in the two section. Maximal clicks cannot be contained by other clicks, and maximal edges cannot be contained by other edges. Now, if we have a hypergraph H that satisfies the condition that every click in the two section is contained by some edge in H, and we have any maximal click M in the two section, then whatever edge contains M must be a maximal by inclusion edge, for if it weren't, M would not be a maximal click. Not only does that edge contain M, it has to be exactly M, because if that edge and M were not equal, then there would be a click larger than M that contains M, a contradiction. Also, any maximal by inclusion edge, W, must be a click in the two section. But it also has to be a maximal click in the two section, because otherwise, there'd be a click larger than W in the two section that contains W. And by our theorem's condition, we can then conclude that there's an edge larger than W that contains W, which contradicts the fact that W is a maximal edge. So it must be that the set of maximal edges of H and the set of maximal clicks of the two section are the same, which is just another way of saying H is conformal. Let's move on to our second theorem. The theorem is: a hypergraph is conformal if and only if the hypergraph does not have isolated vertices, and for any three edges, the union of their pairwise intersections is entirely contained by some edge. To see why this is true, let's take it one direction at a time. To prove the direction shown here, note that the part about there being no isolated vertices comes easily from the fact that conformal hypergraphs do not have isolated vertices. Our previous theorem will be useful for the other part. Suppose we have three edges in a conformal hypergraph H. First, notice that the union of the pairwise intersections must be a clique in the two section of the hypergraph, because any vertex contained in both E1 and E2 is adjacent to any vertex contained in both E1 and E3, and any vertex contained in both E1 and E2 is adjacent to any vertex contained in both E2 and E3. And finally, any vertex contained in both E2 and E3 is adjacent to any vertex contained in both E1 and E3. Since the unions of the intersections is a clique, and our previous theorem states that for conformal hypergraphs, any clique in the two section is contained by some edge, then there must be some edge E4 that contains the union of our pairwise intersections, proving this direction of our theorem. What about the other direction of our theorem? To see why this is true, let's suppose we have a hypergraph H that satisfies our property. What we're going to show is that it implies that any clique in the two section is contained by some edge, which by our first theorem is equivalent to showing the hypergraph is conformal. We're going to induct on clique size in the two section of our hypergraph. Any clique of size 1 in the two section represents a vertex in the hypergraph that's contained by a singleton edge, as otherwise our hypergraph would have isolated vertices. So any clique of size 1 is contained by some edge. Any clique of size 2 in the two section, which is just an edge between two vertices in the two section, represents a set of two vertices in the hypergraph that are adjacent, or in other words, they're contained by the same edge. Therefore, there's an edge in the hypergraph that contains this clique. We verified that any clique in the two section is contained by some edge in the hypergraph for cliques of size 1 and 2. For our inductive step, we'll show that if this holds for cliques of size less than k, then it holds for cliques of size k as well. Let y be a clique of size k in the two section of h, and choose three distinct vertices from y. Next, let y1 be the set y without vertex x1, y2 the set y without vertex x2, and y3 the set y without vertex x3. Each of these sets are also cliques in the two section because they're subsets of y, and they're all of size less than k. By our inductive hypothesis, there's an edge in the hypergraph that contains y1, an edge in the hypergraph that contains y2, and an edge in the hypergraph that contains y3. We'll call these edges d1, d2, and d3 respectively. It's straightforward to verify that y is the union of the pairwise intersections between y1, y2, and y3. From this, we can conclude that y is a subset of the pairwise intersections between d1, d2, and d3. Which are the hypergraph edges that we know by the inductive hypothesis contain the sets y1, y2, and y3. All that's left is to apply our theorem's condition, which is that the union of the pairwise intersections of any three edges is contained in some edge. In this case, that means the union of the pairwise intersections of d1, d2, and d3 is contained by some edge d4. And since clique y is a subset of this union of intersections, clique y is also contained in d4. Therefore, for a hypergraph without isolated vertices that satisfies our theorem's condition, cliques of any size must be contained by some edge in the hypergraph. And as we know from theorem 1, this is equivalent to being conformal. Isn't it neat that we now have three equivalent ways of describing conformal hypergraphs? They are the hypergraphs whose maximal by inclusion edges are the maximal cliques of the two section, or equivalently, they're the hypergraphs whose two sections cliques are always contained by some hypergraph edge, or equivalently, they're the hypergraphs where the union of the pairwise intersections of any three edges is contained by some edge. There's one last theorem I'd like to show you, and it's going to give us yet another way to describe conformal hypergraphs. The theorem is, a hypergraph is conformal if and only if its dual is Helly and has no empty edges. If you recall from my previous video, a hypergraph is Helly if for every set of mutually adjacent edges, there's some vertex that is incident to all of those edges. Let's work on one direction at a time. Suppose we have a conformal hypergraph H. Informally, any set of mutually adjacent edges in the dual of H corresponds to a set of mutually adjacent vertices in H. And by theorem 1 and H's conformality, for every set of mutually adjacent vertices in H, there's an edge in H that contains that set. So it must be that for every set of mutually adjacent edges in the dual of H, there's a vertex contained by all edges in that set. In other words, it must be that the dual has the Helly property. Since conformal hypergraphs do not have isolated vertices, their duals will not have empty edges, proving this direction of our theorem. Next, what about the other direction? Suppose we have a hypergraph H whose dual is Helly and has no empty edges. Since the dual is Helly and has no empty edges, we can say that for every set of edges that are mutually adjacent, there is some vertex that is incident to all of them. Intuitively, we know that sets of mutually adjacent vertices in the original become sets of mutually adjacent edges in the dual and vice versa. So if we know that all sets of mutually adjacent edges in the dual have some vertex that is incident to all of them at once, then we know that all sets of mutually adjacent vertices in the original have some edge that's incident to all of them at once. By theorem 1, this is equivalent to saying that the original is conformal. So, we now have 4 equivalent ways of saying a hypergraph is conformal. Also, if we consider hypergraphs without empty edges, then our latest theorem leaves us with 4 options for hypergraphs. A hypergraph can be conformal and not Helly with a Helly and not conformal dual, or a hypergraph can be conformal and Helly with a conformal and Helly dual, or a hypergraph can be Helly and not conformal with a conformal and not Helly dual, or a hypergraph and its dual can both be neither conformal nor Helly. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and click the like button. Have a great day.